So B.F. Skinner studied rats and pigeons in an operant conditioning chamber, which is called a Skinner box. Inside the Skinner box, they have a food dispenser and a lever that the rat can press. Other conditioning chambers have things such as lights as well. Now you might wonder, why did Skinner look at rats and pigeons in a Skinner box? Well, it turns out that what he learned from the Skinner box can be applied to humans, meaning the information from the animals generalizes to human behavior as well. First, we want to know, why does the rat first press the lever? Well, it turns out rats are exploratory creatures, meaning they will walk around their environment and check it out. And so when the rat is first placed in the Skinner box, it may go over to the corner, stand up and smell the walls, but eventually it may come over and bump into the lever or stand on it to smell something up here. When that first occurrence happens, we can deliver a food pellet to the rat. But how do we get the rat to press the lever again? We can get the rat to press the lever through the process of shaping. And shaping is reinforcing successive approximations to the final target behavior. So if the rat were standing over here in the corner, I wouldn't deliver a food pellet. However, if the rat started to approach the lever, I could deliver a food pellet. Eventually, you reinforce those behaviors that are closest to the final one. Shaping is important for many of our operant conditioning behaviors.